Welcome back. It's Sports This Morning on Channels Television. We're celebrating 21 years of professional broadcasting. Tyus, since we're ready, go to the new studio.
Yeah, surely. I mean, we heard Federer, you know, discuss the speaks, and we're about to go to the new attack as well now, too. I don't know what he's thinking. What are you tipping to win the U.S. Open for the men and women?
Well, that's putting me on the spot. But
yeah,
who am I to contradict Federer?
Come on, guys. It says it's Djokovic and Serena Williams. Mm-hmm. You might say Kai Nishikori and Angelique Kerber.
Come on.
I'll say this again. Who am I to contradict Federer? No. I personally would have wished Federer was still on there.
Okay.
You know, but hey, he's out, and he has already told you, I'm looking to see this two people take the trophy. So let's see how it plays out at the end of the day. But enough of the tennis. Let's go to the headlines. Military operations in Bayelsa State appear to have suffered a setback in a special exercise codenamed Operation Crocodile Smile. Two soldiers are feared to have drowned after a boat mishap along the Brass waterfront in Brass local government area. Soldiers are said to be members of a special military operation going on there and being activated in other states of the Niger Delta. Some residents of Brass told Channels Television that efforts to rescue the soldiers failed owing to the high tide. Meanwhile, the military is reaching out to the militants in the Niger Delta in efforts to secure lasting peace. The Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Tukur Burete, is asking the agitators to come up with a single position if their demands are to be treated seriously. General Burete was speaking in Port Harcourt, the River State capital, on the sidelines of a closed-door meeting with heads of security agencies and representatives of oil companies. He explains that the military operations should not be mistaken for an invasion. And in spite of relevant laws against human trafficking in the country, the menace continues. This is according to officials of the National Agency for the Prohibition of Trafficking in Persons, NAPTIP. The agency's Director for Public Enlightenment, Mr. Orakwe Arinze, believes the incidents can be brought down drastically if the twin issues of poverty and unemployment are addressed effectively. And the Ethiopian government has agreed or admitted that 23 people have died following a fire that broke out at the maximum security Quintilo jail on Saturday in the capital Addis Ababa. A statement from the government said 21 people suffocated at the scene of the fire, while two others died while trying to escape. Local media said the fire was preceded by intense gunfire and the fire was started deliberately by people who wanted to escape. Photos released on social media on Saturday showed plumes of smoke rising from the prison compound. Those are the headlines. Back to Tayo and Austin.
All right, thank you so much, Nyotaigbe, for the update. When you're back tomorrow, you tell us, because we will not take the response from Roger
Federer. That was great.
From you. You will watch, and then you will tell us if you're going against the champion.
Austin, you really want me to respond to that?
I'm waiting for you tomorrow. Leave it to you tomorrow. Okay, thank you so much, Nyotaigbe. Welcome back from our new studio to Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria, where the action never ends. I keep telling you, it's an action-packed morning. It's been an exciting, interesting, engaging world of sports. Don't just watch the show. Come, let us play for the love of the game. Time to get you involved on Twitter, where Channels underscore sports, Facebook, Channels Life in Sports. You can send us an email to sportsthismorning@channelstv.com. We told you it's now one more day. The 2016 Paralympic Games are upon us. One more game tomorrow. Action will begin at the Paralympic Games. You know the story, Team Nigeria, they're already in Rio. 23 athletes, Nigeria will be competing in para table tennis, athletics, and of course, powerlifting. Just to also let you know that on the program this morning, you can talk to us in the hashtag Paralympic Games. Just one more day. Paralympic Games, hashtag US Open, hashtag MPFL in Nigeria. As table tennis is working, lawn tennis, they're saying, they must keep talking about tennis. They are also working. We'll give you all the updates from that one. And of course, the Nigerian Professional Football League, so much talking points. This week is Wiki Tories. The following week, Enugu Rangers, we bounce back. come again, Rivers United. It's been a competitive league, and we will be trying to understand Enugu Rangers and what is playing football for them this season. They want to make history. They want to break records. So that's the menu for the show this morning. Oh, let's chit-chat Enugu Rangers and their fine form tire.
Yeah.
What do you think is motivating that team?
Austin, I mean, the obvious one is the fact that they haven't won the title for a very long time.
That's right.
32 years is a long time for a big, traditional club like Rangers to go without winning the title. So I can imagine that's one of the main, motivation for them. Apart from that, they've got a great side.
Yeah.
I mean, they've got some really, really good players.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, arguably, from back to front, you say they have, some of the best players in the league.
I agree.
I'm not really surprised they're on top at the moment. But it has gotten to a stage now where the pressure is on them now. You know, bookmakers are actually tipping them to go on and win the title. That adds a lot of pressure to the team. And it will be very interesting to see how they cope in this kind of situation. I mean, they've hung on for so long.
Yeah.
They've been very consistent. I don't think they've been out of the top four in a long time. That's a sign of a team, that wants to win. So they will need, some luck on the way now.
I agree.
With a few games left.
Just four more games to go. Wiki, they have an outstanding. Anybody have an outstanding.
Yeah.
So that's what Enugu Rangers will be looking at. Look, from now to the end of the season, we need to pick points, win games at home, and pick points away from home. I'm talking about their last victory against Rivers United. When you beat Rivers United, that is in fine form, by 4-0, you don't just look only at the players. You go back, look at the technical crew.
Yeah.
Coach Imama Amakatago, he has done a very good job with the team. No surprise. Look at the rise he's having in his career.
I mean, and
he's staying focused.
Yes,
he's not talking much. He's telling his players, stay disciplined. You can be part of history.
Exactly. I mean, it's done. Yeah, he's done a very decent job, Austin. I mean, like you said, in terms of his the progression in his career, we've seen him make the step up to the Super Eagles as well. To see him combine those two roles, I think it's very impressive for our coach, Imama. We're going to get the opportunity to go and talk to him.
Fantastic.
He's going to, tell us about his plans for the rest of the season, the targets. You know, when you're in this kind of situation, sometimes they're going to target some games where they want to get, full points. There are going to be games where they want to get just 1 point. We'll see whether that's the case with
totally
Coach Imama.
I agree with you. Tayo, let's go to the camp of Enugu Rangers, Coach Imama Amakakabo. Yeah, get that name right. He's standing by to talk to us on the program. Coach Imama, good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning.
Fantastic. I see you are turbocharged. That's the kind of presence we see when Enugu Rangers, they are playing. Talk to us. What is playing football for Enugu Rangers this season?
I think, first of all, let me say my philosophy. You know, I said last season when I came in interimly that I inherited a team, but then that people will get to appreciate my team. You know, I went out looking for players that will be able to, like, interpret my philosophy of the game. And I think so far, so good. 34 weeks down the road, and we are where we are today.
Okay, Coach, I mean, you're on top now. You've been very consistent all season. Bookmakers are actually, tipping Rangers to go on and win the title. Have you started feeling the pressure yet?
What pressure? You know, nobody expected us to be where we are. Nobody gave us a chance. So, like I tell my lads all the time, we just have to just go do the same thing that we do and enjoy ourselves. You know, let's go have fun, And so long as we do the things that we are doing that are taking us to this point, no pressure. Let's forget about the crowd.
Yeah.
Let's forget about the expectations of people. What people talk about 32 years and all. You know, it will happen. Let's just keep doing what we are doing, Forget about every other person.
I know.
It's okay if we lose, you know. But then, so long as we keep doing what we are doing, we can't be losing. We'll just keep on winning. That's just it.
I agree with you, Coach. About four more games to the end of the season. This is a delicate part in league football, business. And what is Enugu Rangers is going to do to ensure that they retain their position at the top of the table?
Trust me, Enugu Rangers is not going to do anything differently. We're going to keep on pressing high. We're going to keep on, having value for the ball. We're going to keep possessing the ball. We're going to create as many chances as we'll be able to create any game that we play. We're going to go with belief in ourselves, in our abilities. We're going to go dribble some people, shoot at goal. And whatever happens, we take it up from there. four games to go, 12 points to play for. Any Rangers is playing for every one of those points. We are not looking at any person around us. All we need to do is to keep focused and run as fast and as hard as we possibly can. And come 2nd of October, we'll see what happens from there.
Tayo, they will dribble some people. They will shoot at goal. When you look at your remaining fixtures, which of your opponents worry you?
Like I said, you know, I don't bother about, you know, we started this competition with 19 other teams. You know, unfortunately, one team has dropped out, so we have 18 other teams around us. And we keep focus with the 18 other teams. Any team could be champion. Even if Kodobi United are down there. We don't know, nothing. In football, nothing is impossible, you know. So we just must play with every other team. Like I said, while our heads are held high, we are just running straight. You know, the finish line is in sight, and if we run as fast and as hard as we possibly can, yes, I think we'll finish well.
Okay, Coach Mama, let's just, you know, just go away from Rangers now. Let's go to the Super Eagles. I mean, you were part of the team, you know, that that beat Tanzania. I mean, part of the coaching crew that beat Tanzania 1-0 over the weekend. What was the experience like, you know, and has it been easy for you to transition from club football to national team football?
You know, my definition of a team and a club is this: national team, you know. Experts that have been brought together to perform a certain function. Club side, people that have been around, that stayed, that have decided to stay for quite some time. So, Imama has to leave from my club, which I am boss, to a national team, which I have some other bosses. And I have to function because there are all experts there who just come together for a few days and we execute this. But I think most importantly, we needed a win. The country needed a win to boost us, you know, and give us belief in ourselves, because we were not getting results that was helping us, and people were beginning to doubt. You know, the World Cup qualifiers are around the corner, and with this win, you know, under our belt, I think everybody now is happy. We believe in what we are able to do. We have a new head coach that has also come with his philosophy, that wants to work with everybody, giving everybody a belief, you know, and I think it's a plus for the country.
Coach, you are now a general of Nigerian League football. I gave you that rank, Coach Imama. A lot of followers of league football in Nigeria frowned at the fact that we didn't get to see our local players feature in Ross's team. Is it that we don't have the quality that can compete with these foreign-based guys?
Listen, I think I am blessed and, you know, privileged to have traveled with our Europe-based players and our home-based players too. In fact, I used to be one of those that says, look, man, our local-based players should be in the team all the time. But trust me, after my experience in Spain, I just got to know that, look, if you put the collection of our local-based players together to play against, you know, our Europe-based teams, it will always be a challenge. Trust me. I speak from the point of knowledge now, from the point of knowing. You know, because, but then, if you take one or two of our players and put into the Europe-based teams, they will do well. Because the speed of our game here, let us face facts, you know, the Nigerian player in terms of intelligence on what to do on the part, every part of the pitch, because the pitch is divided, is low, because from the grassroots level, we get it wrong. Technically, most of our players just play football and don't understand what the game is all about. You know, so sometimes we don't have value, which is one of the things I try to preach in my team. You know, on certain areas of the pitch that you should be sensitive and not lose the ball. But you see, when our players blend, one or two of them go to Europe, they get know these things, and they come back, they are better people. So if you put our Europe-based players together, I think they know, you know, what to do. But when you put our local-based players, you know, yes, one or two of them will be able to break into the team to do well with our Europe-based players. But I think at all times, at this point in time, I agree completely that, you know, our Europe-based players have, you know, an edge over our local-based player.
Thank you so much, Coach Imama, for speaking to us. You're not just a good coach, you're also a fine football analyst. It's a space down there for you. After the league season, come around, let's talk Nigerian League football. Thank you so much.
God bless you. Thank you for having me.
Okay, yeah, so that's it, Coach Imama.
He had to end it all with the vote of confidence for local best based on players. I mean, the talent is not in doubt, Austin. There's no two ways about it. The edge he's talking about is the fact that these foreign guys are exposed.
That's right.
You know, the experience that they play against the absolute best in Europe. So that stands for something. But in terms of the talent, it's not a big deal at all. So I wouldn't be surprised even, you know, a couple of them, you know, break into the team.
Imam, I was very sincere. We're still talking sports right here, Channel TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. Another quick break. When we come back, so much to talk about. Don't go anywhere. Stay.